just like how we established that God written down the guidelines of how we should follow, we ourselves have to humble down and follow those guidelines. Now let's see what the guidelines are for repentance. Let me get 1 Kings chapter 8.
1 Kings chapter 8 and verse 46. If they sin against thee.
Because I want you to really take heed to this, what's coming out right now. Really take heed to this, okay? Now read it again.
If they sin against thee.
Because all men have sinned. All the Israelite people have sinned. You understand me, okay? Sinning is breaking God's commandments.
Right.
Going against what's written in the Bible. You understand?
Right.
Let's keep reading.
For there is no man that sinneth not.
Ain't none of us got it right yet, but we working on it.
Teach.
Keep reading.
And thou be angry with them.
So God was angry with us. What did he do?
And deliver them to the enemy.
So we were delivered to the enemies. If we look at what happened in our history, we were delivered unto our enemies. We were enslaved for 400 years.
Right.
Now that time is coming to a close, Paul. Because Christ is coming back any day now.
Right.
Let's keep reading.
So that they carry them away captives unto the land of the enemy, far or near.
See, the Bible is talking about our history right now. It says we are carried away to our captors, our oppressors, far or near, meaning close to Africa and very far away from Africa, all over the world. We know that's to be true. Now, let's keep reading.
Yet, if they shall bethink themselves.
It says, but if you shall bethink yourself. Paul, the word bethink means remember. Remember. You take pride. You have kids.
I have one son.
Now, let's say your son did not know who you are anymore. Are you going to be proud of that? What if he didn't take pride of being your son? That's how God feels when you don't take pride in being called the children of Israel.
Yes, that's right.
That's how God feels. Matter of fact, what does the word Israel mean? Hold what you got. Let's get what Israel means. Because we're not just feeble men.
Right.
The officer said that we are gods. I knew that went over your head. Because we don't live like gods. We die like men. But we were created special.
Right.
Read what you got.
Genesis chapter 32 and verse 28. And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob.
So your name shall be called no more Paul, feeble man Williams. You understand me? You got to break your mind. You got to bethink yourself. Meaning come back to the strength and the power and glory of your father.
Right.
Read.
Thy name shall be called no more Jacob.
It's no more called whatever they called you.
But Israel.
But what?
But Israel.
That's what God calls you.
Right.
That's what God wants you to know yourself as. Because that's why he said the first thing you got to do, Paul, is bethink yourself.
Right.
Remember yourself.
Right.
If you don't know who you are, how are you going to govern yourself based off of the Bible?
Right.
How does anything in the Bible when it say children of Israel make sense to you if you don't even recognize you're children of Israel?
Right.
It's addressed to you, Paul. So no more can you subscribe to be called African American,
right,
or black, or colored, or Negro. None of these things pertain to us. Now let's go back to the whole matter of fact, read what you got, because we passed it.
For as a prince hast thou power with God.
As a prince, we have power with God.
That's
right. Don't you want power with God? Don't you want that special connection with God?
Jeez.
Don't you want God to look down and smile and be proud of you and see you as a product of himself?
Right.
Don't you know that you made in God's image?
Right.
You look
right
like his son, Jesus the Christ?
Right.
Right. Everybody else.
No, everybody is not, Paul.
Bring it out.
Check this out. You say everybody of who?
Adam don't.
Everybody of everybody or everybody of Israel?
No. Everybody don't follow Christ.
We understand that.
When I wake up in the morning and my problems over my face and my heart, there's something wrong there. Why would I want to come out with a man faith for things ain't going my way?
Because we're oppressed. Matter of fact, let me show you this, what the Bible say. I do come out with a mad phrase because I'm mad as hell.
Right.
You don't know why I'm mad? Because oppression make a wise man mad, Paul.
That's right.
If you're living in a dump, but you should be in that palace over there, wouldn't you be a little upset?
Yeah.
Wouldn't you be a little upset if they take your mother and they rape the... Wouldn't you be a little upset if they took your son and killed him? Wouldn't you be a little upset? We know this world is for your sakes, Paul,
right,
and we gotta live in hell.
Right.
So hell yeah, I'm mad. Because the Bible says so. Read.
Ecclesiastes chapter 7 and verse 7.
Bring it out.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
The only time you're going to get up off your behind and change is when you get mad.
Right.
So, Paul, I need you to get mad. I don't need you to riot. I don't need you to hurt nobody. We ain't teaching no violence. I need you to get mad enough at yourself to say, you know what? I will hold myself to subjection to what my God has in store for me.
Right.
I'm mad enough to stop eating shrimp, crab, lobster. I'm mad enough to stop shaving my beard. Because these are things that God said we are not supposed to do.
Right.
You can start even today. What's going on, cowboy? What's going on, bro? How you doing, man? Hey, come on at me right quick. Come look at some of the signs. You ain't got nowhere else to go. Everything's shut down. I was telling my brother Paul here that we are not just feeble men. You believe that? Do you believe we special?
No.
You don't think we special? Let me show you how special we are. Deuteronomy 7 and 6. God said we are so special. I mean so special. He wrote this in his book. The question is, are you going to humble down to what's written in the book? And if you don't believe in the book, guess what? Guess what? I can work with that too. Because I can show you things that's happening right now. Okay. You say you're a Muslim. Okay. So you're a member of a church. Cool. We're going to deal with this. Let me see if your church have ever told you this. What's your name, brother?
Frank.
Paul Frank. All right. Cool.
Deuteronomy.
Kaz and I, by the way.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6.
Bring it out.
For thou art an holy people.
So, Paul, now you've been here for a little bit, right? Uh-huh. Did God already identify who his holy people was? Is it talking about everybody of everybody, or is it talking about a group of people?
Well, the way I look at it, he's talking about a group of people who follow us.
A group of people that follow him, but you out of your own mouth said everybody don't follow him.
Not on your own understanding.
Okay.
So
Paul, can you find a scripture for the statement that you just made?
Well,
so you're leaning on your own understanding.
No, he said
the Bible says
not on your own.
I know. So you're leaning on your own understanding, Paul, because that's not what the Bible says.
Bring it out.
The Bible says he chose the children of Israel.
Right.
He didn't show you that, Paul.
Yeah,
matter of fact, let's read.
Bring it up.
So Frank, let's see if your church ever told you this though.
Bring it out.
First thing they heard was they went to church on the wrong day.
They're
supposed to be at church right now because today is the Sabbath day.
Right.
If you know your Ten Commandments, it say keep the Sabbath day holy, right?
Right.
The seventh day has always been today,
right?
Not tomorrow. So that's strike one against the Antichrist doctrine.
Right.
You understand? The Antichrist doctrine got you wearing that chain right now.
Right.
The Antichrist doctrine right now got you not knowing who you are or don't even knowing that you're special. Read this.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6. For thou art an holy people.
God said, for thou art a holy people. He's talking about the Israelites, Paul. He's not talking about just anybody if anybody. He's only talking to the Israelites. Let me prove it. Deuteronomy 1 and 1.
Read up.
Let's see if the subject matter changes. Let's see if anything changes. Because at the end of the day, the Bible's to the Israelites, for the Israelites, and as you now know, it's by the Israelites.
Right.
Guess what? You share a name of our forefathers that wrote the Bible.
Right.
Did we not just read about Paul himself? So the thing is, we made them in the same images as these men. So we can't deny it. We can't play around no more.
Right.
God is not playing no more. Read what you got.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1.
Bring it out.
These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Oh, what about the whole world? What about everybody else?
Unto all Israel.
So you know he's not dealing with the other nations.
Right.
That's why it's an abomination for us to marry outside of our race.
Right.
Give me Deuteronomy 73. Because at the end of the day, we're not supposed to have interracial marriages.
Right.
That is an abomination that kills our people today.
Yeah.
Read what you got.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 3. Neither shalt thou make marriages with them.
You shall not make marriages with them.
Thy daughter thou shalt not give unto his son.
Your daughter you shall not give to their sons.
Nor his daughter shalt thou take unto thy son.
Why did the Lord say that? Read.
For they will turn away thy son from following me.
It's going to turn your heart away from your creator.
That's
you
right.
cannot be for your people married to the enemy.
Right.
Now let's get back to what the word of God was saying for y'all brothers.
Teach.
Another reason why we special, right? If we special, but then we give the special thing to everybody else, then what's special? What's special about it?
Bring it out.
If we gave what made us special to everybody, is it special? So how are we gonna give our lineage, our bloodline, our genes, the best thing a man could ever create, which is his seed, and give it to the other nations?
Right.
We giving our strength to the other nations. We giving our wealth to the other nations. So that concept alone shows you that God does not want us with everybody else. Let's see what God said about us again. Deuteronomy 7 and 6.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6.
Bring it out.
Thou art an holy people.
The word holy means set apart, separate. Read.
Unto the Lord thy God.
Uh-huh.
The Lord thy God have chosen thee.
He has chosen us. Meaning, just like how you got different shoes, right? You chose to wear those shoes, right? You chose to put on that shirt, right? But you got other shirts. So out of all the other people, God chose the nation of Israel.
That's right.
The Lord thy God have chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
He chose you, Frank, to be special unto himself.
That's right.
Read.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
So get equality out of that.
Yeah.
Guess what? We fought and died for civil rights. Then we fought and died for equal rights. Are they civil with us?
Bring it
are
out.
They equal with us now? No.
Out.
So we've been fighting in vain. We've been fighting for something that, guess what? We better than them anyway. We
right.
shouldn't want to be equal to them. They don't want to be equal to us.
Bring
they done shown that. So why are we the only people that want to be equal?
Teach.
Why are we the only people that want to bring them with us?
Bring it out.
Why are we the only people that want to share the gift of God with everybody else when they ain't sharing a damn thing with you?
That's right.
If you got $1 million, are you going to share that $1 million with the rest of the world, or are you going to break bread with your family?
Bring it out.
Are you going to blow that money on strangers? Guess what? God said, I created this kingdom. I'm not blowing it on no strangers.
Right.
He's giving it to the children of Israel.
Right.
Let me prove it to you. Let me get Isaiah 14 and 1. Let's see what the future prophecy says about the coming glory, kingdom of heaven.
Right.
That's one of my favorite scriptures, Paul.
Bring it up.
Listen up, Frank, because you ain't going to hear this in your Sunday school either.
Right.
Did you know slavery was in the Bible? Did you know? Matter of fact, I'ma just let you hear it. Because you thought slavery was in the Bible for us to be slaves. Oh no. Let's see what God has in store for these nations.
Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 1.
Bring it out.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
So God said he's going to have mercy on Jacob. You know who Jacob is, brother? Right? Do they teach who Jacob is? Well, you know, matter of fact, hold what you got. Go to Exodus 3 and 6. Now, I know you heard this statement before. I'm going to read it to you. And then I want you to really ponder on why it's so significant to know who Jacob is.
Tell me
all right?
On the right.
Read what you got.
Exodus chapter 3 and verse 6.
Bring it out.
Moreover, he said, I am the God of thy father.
Who's this talking? This the Most High God, right? So let's listen to what the word of God is saying. What is God about to say right now? Read.
I am the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob.
What about everybody else? Why do you use a particular bloodline? Why do you use a particular family?
Jesus.
He said, I am the God of these people, not the God of everybody else. That's why you got to know who Jacob is, brother. They don't teach you in the church because they teach you lies. They want your money.
Bring it out.
Now let's go back to Isaiah.
Whoa.
Now that you know who Jacob is, or now that you know who God cares about Jacob, let's listen to the scriptures.
Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 1.
Yeah.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
He's going to have mercy on Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Jacob changed his name to the 12 tribes. He's the forefather of these people right here. The 12 tribes of Israel.
Right.
Who we all descend from.
Right.
Another thing they'll teach you in church. Let's keep reading.
And will yet choose Israel.
He's going to choose Israel. He's not going to choose all nations of everybody and everybody.
Right.
That's why it's important, Paul, for you to understand who you are. That's why it's important, Paul, for you to bethink yourself. And no, you ain't got to go. Yeah, check us out, brother. We ain't got a lot of time. The scriptures say the wicked flee when none pursue it, bro.
Right.
You don't want to get your blessing? Well, maybe it ain't for you, bro. But I guarantee you this, you're going to remember this day, you're going to remember these words.
Right.
Read.
And set them in their own land.
This is what you're turning your back on. Us going back into rulership. Us getting our own land. You're going to walk away from that?
Read.
And the strangers shall be joined with them.
So you rather side with the strangers than to side with the men of God.
Right.
Read.
And they shall cleave to the house of Jacob.
All these other nations gonna recognize us for who we are, Paul. And they're gonna cleave to us, meaning they're gonna follow us. They're gonna follow our example. They're gonna lean on for everything we say. They're gonna obey us. We are gonna be the authority and the ruling class. You understand? There's not one society that does not have a ruling class and a servant class. If you don't think so, you don't know society.
Right.
And chances are, your ass is in the servant class.
Right.
Read.
And the people shall take them and bring them to their place.
So we're gonna take all these other people, all these people we see around us, all these other nations, all these strangers, what are we gonna do with them?
And the house of Israel shall possess them.
You possess your shoes, right? You possess that cane, right? You possess your house, right? You possess those glasses on your face, right? These are all your property, right? So God said we shall what with these other people?
And the house of Israel shall possess them.
We're going to possess them just like I possess my car, my shoes, my house, my dog.
Right.
It's all going to belong to me. And I'm going to put my name on it.
That's right.
Read.
Possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids.
You see that, Paul? We're going to have servants and handmaids of these other nations.
Right.
Do you ever marry to help? No, do you marry your slaves? Are you supposed to marry your slaves? Is a king supposed to marry his subjects?
No.
Royalty only supposed to be with royalty, right?
That's right.
So if you married all these other subjects, what's going to happen to your kingdom?
Bring it
out. It's going to diminish, right? That's why God set us apart. That's also why God said we're not supposed to marry our subjects.
Right.
Because God said we're going to be in rulership.
Bring it out.
Absolutely. And guess what? Who's the only people equal to the children of Israel? Other children of Israel.
That's
there
right.
Is none better.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.